to talk winners and losers with our financial expert, Rob Black. Hi, Rob.
Hey, Daria.
Okay, so is it win or lose today on Wall Street?
Kind of a loser. Stocks are struggling. It's the end of March. It's a negative quarter, January, February, March. First time since March of 2020, which is when we had COVID breakout and people panicked. But all things considered, it's not that bad. S&P 500 is down 3% for the year. The Dow is down about 3%, and the Nasdaq's down 7%. I would take that every year if we can get those 10-year returns in front of it. But oil's a little bit lower today as Biden's talking about opening strategic reserves. Initial jobless claims are lower. Employers don't want you leaving. They don't want you going anywhere anytime soon. And interesting to note, Chris Rock tickets, Daria,
yeah,
up 641% since Sunday evening's Oscars telecast. So $50 tickets are now going for as much as $1,500, $1,600 per ticket.
I know. Everybody wanted to know what happened because, you know, yesterday he played for the first time in Boston, and then he's going to be coming to Oakland. So I think that everybody wants to support him.
Why did you and I think of this and buy tickets on Monday morning for every show
we've done for him? Oh, I thought you meant like you slap me or I slap you and then we get, like, that'd be a long way to go, Rob, for fans. Yeah. He didn't
Daria
want to slap.
Some G.I. Jane, too.
He didn't. Oh, don't make me. Well, speaking of which, by the way, just can we say, your hair's getting long.
I'm going to get chopped today.
Oh, you are? It's a little unruly. No, I mean, I like it. It's just not like you all buttoned up. Oh my gosh. Okay.
So,
what? What? But, you know, you're a business guy.
You call me tight. I get it.
You keep the hair tight. Gosh. Okay. When it comes to this home market, what I've been noticing is you have to make your offer like with the fastest close in cash and no contingency as in no inspections. And I worry about that because stuff can go wrong.
It went wrong for me. I bought a house last year and I sold a house that was in loving and in good condition. I bought a house that a owner had turned into a slumlord and basically let it get out of hand. It was featured in magazines as a dream home. The reality is it had a lot of problems, but 77% of buyers last year had to spend over $1,000 on major repairs. That's 6 million homeowners, roughly. So you can do the math there. I had $10,000 in plumbing. I found out that I had some bad drains when I woke up to a waterfall in my kid's room. $3,000 for a pool crack, $60,000 for the original heater to be removed with $5,000 of asbestos on top of it, $40,000 for a new roof. Who is the smartest financial guy at Cron?
Wait a minute.
Not me today.
Okay, but you knew this going in because I don't care if you didn't get an inspection. You just said it was like a slum thing. And
it was beautiful. It was gorgeous. It was literally in Marin Magazine as a dream home.
Wait, and it had all these hidden problems?
It's kind of like a photo shoot, Daria, where you can get all prettied up and put makeup on the pimples. And you look lovely when you're taking the photos, but when you take a shower, it's not quite as good.
Wow.
I bought a fixer-upper, and I didn't realize it was that much of a fixer-upper. So what I'm trying to get at is even I make mistakes. I have emergency funds, so I'm okay.
Right.
But it's been an expensive year.
Yeah, and I think it's buyer beware. If you're going to do something like that and make an offer to try to win the house, right?
Right.
Oh, I've got something for those of you. If you like to smoke organic, you tell them.
It's cheaper if you grow it yourself, but there's a marijuana legalization bill in front of Congress on Friday. It's the Marijuana or Opportunity Reinvestment Expungement Act, also known as MORE. It's all about decriminalizing marijuana, but also about getting the a federal charter involved so that banking can be done. The number one place to rob right now are marijuana dispensaries, in large part because they deal mostly in cash. With midterm elections, I don't know if this is going to get through because the Republicans probably want to stymie it. I bring it up because a few years ago, there was crazy investments in marijuana and people got caught up in it and hurt themselves. But Martha Stewart, Snoop Dogg, Mike Tyson all have marijuana lines, gummy lines. The way to play it, if you're going to play it, is Canopy Growth because they're owned a large part by a major alcohol distributor. So, that's the only way I would play it is if you're getting it with something else.
I see.
I wouldn't do a pure play per se on marijuana.
And no, you're not going to go for it's a budding industry. No dad joke? Would you like, I'm going to set you up. No?
No G.I. Jane, no dad joke.
Okay. We'll see you, Robbie. If you have any questions for Rob, see you later. Go get your haircut. You can email him or reach him on Facebook or Twitter.